Hi, my name is Mauricio and welcome to this latest Cloudwards at End video. Today, we'll be comparing Trello and Monday.com, two very useful project management tools, to see which one is the better fit for you and your business. Now, as you can see, we're covering more and more project management tools, and if you like that, well, leave a comment to know, well, so that we know which project management software we should cover next. And also, obviously, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you want to know about remote work, file management in the cloud, and how to organize your team better. So let's talk Kanban boards now, shall we? The reason I bring up Kanban boards is because that's how we'll be comparing these two providers. Monday.com is a full service project management solution, the best out there, in fact. But Trello really only offers a Kanban board. It has other functionality, as we'll see, but unless you're using it primarily as a Kanban board, all you're doing is ramming a square peg in a round hole. But I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Let's first talk a bit about Kanban boards. They were invented in Japan and were first used in the Toyota car factories. Each board is divided into columns, with each row having cards assigned. Usually, people make the columns represent stages of a task, so to do, doing, and done, say, while individual tasks are represented by the cards. Kanban boards have a few things going for them, but the best feature by far is the ability to drag and drop cards at will at the respective stages. In this example, we use Trello because it might be the best Kanban board out there. And that's a good thing because Trello doesn't offer much else. If you want more than just a Kanban board, you're going to have to use Trello's power-up system. This is where our problems with Trello come in. On the free plan, you only get one power-up, and pretty much anything needs one. For example, something as high-end as a Gantt chart is a power-up, as is the time tracking. What's also a power-up is the calendar, which in our opinion is actually pretty important, especially if, say, you are working with an editorial team, you have to publish content on the web, and you want to put everything on certain dates and want to have a nice monthly overview of what you're doing. The solution may seem obvious, namely to sign up for Trello. It's only $10 per user per month and gives you unlimited power-ups as well as some other goodies. The thing is, though, that it's not really worth it. The most useful power-ups, like the timeline I just mentioned, is actually a paid add-on, meaning you have to shell out twice. Trying to turn Trello into a full project management suite using its power-ups can get pretty pricey that way, as well as being a bit awkward as you tack on modules after module. So, what should a full suite look like? Well, there are a few options, but we think Monday.com hits the nail on the head, mostly thanks to its features. It does a whole lot more than Trello does, and obviously for the same money too. When you go to it from Trello, you may actually feel a little overwhelmed, but that won't last long. Instead of the Kanban board being basically the main screen, it's actually just one of many views or ways to look at the tasks you and your team need to do. Your main input is actually in the list view, which isn't the best way to create an overview, but is a great way to simply put tasks into the system. Say if you have like a very long list of items that you just basically need to dump into the system, and then later you really assign it to different people, assign deadlines, and assign certain dependencies as well. Unlike Trello, you also get way more options for things to add to tasks. So not just due dates, but also priorities and durations. And there are like custom fields that you can really customize to your own needs if you need a dropdown or if you need certain other fields. This makes it much easier to find tasks and organize everything. Once you've all your tasks set up, that's when you can check out different views. The calendar, for example, is built in, and you also have a type of Gantt board in the timeline view. You also have a Kanban board, and in all fairness, we don't like it as much as Trello's, but if you look at the whole package, that becomes irrelevant. The best part of it all is that Monday.com's cheapest good plan starts at $10 too, and look at what you get. So, What's the upshot of all of this? Well, if you need a Kanban board and little to nothing else, then go for Trello's free plan. You've got really nothing to lose because, well, it's free. And, well, you can even, if you invite a few people, you may get a few upgrades here and there. But obviously, if you really want to make use of the full Trello suite, you have to go for the paid plan. But if you're going to spend 10 bucks per user per month, we recommend you go with monday.com. It's better, it's easy to use, and well, it adds a whole lot more flexibility to your project management needs. Well, we hope this video helped you make a decision. And obviously, if so, please like it. You find all the links in the description box below. You can sign up for a free trial to either Trello or monday.com, so you can really check out which project management solution fits your needs best. If you're a current Trello user, you can also import your cards into monday.com, play around with it a little bit. That's what I do when I play around with these software, project management software solutions. I import things that I have in the other one, and then I see if I like the interface, if I can do everything that I really want to do. If you'd like more helpful guides to picking the best project management tools around, obviously also cloud storage management solution, or even VPNs, make sure to subscribe because we cover all of that in this channel and we have over 100 videos in our catalog. So browse around, check out our other videos, and subscribe. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.